Hello there, Frankie. Good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us today from Gresham House, we have the Chief Executive, Tony Dalwood, accompanied by the Chief Financial Officer, once again, Kevin Acton. So warm welcome to you. And just first of all, we're going to delve into the economics of it all, because we're going to talk about an overview of your financial highlights with Kevin. So take it away for the first half of 2022. What do we need to know?
Morning, Katie. Thank you. So we were delighted to report this morning that we've increased our assets under management by 11% in the period, so closing at 7.3 billion. And what was pleasing about that was we had around half a billion of that came from organic growth. So a great story in challenging times. Now, what we're seeing is that is now flowing through to our net core income. So net core income improved by 61% in the period. So it's just over 37 million pounds. And then that has flowed through to our operating profit level. So operating profit was up by 91% to just over 13 million in the period, which is a result of both organic growth as well as the acquisitions we had from Mobius and Appian in the second half of last year. So with that, we're now starting to see the benefit of operational leverage coming through, with our adjusted operating margin now standing at 35% at the end of the period in comparison to the prior year, which was just over 30%. So this is all off the back of a very strong balance sheet where we've invested in the business and grown so far. So all in all, a good first half to the year.
All right, let's get Tony involved now, because it has been a very challenging time from a macroeconomic perspective, really, for everyone. What progress have you made from a strategic point of view, and what are the highlights from the period, would you say, Tony?
Yes, thank you. Good to be here again. And look, I'm particularly pleased because we go back two or three years, we set out our five-year plan in our GH25. And as part of that, that kept us on the rails as to what we wanted to achieve for shareholder value. So I'm particularly pleased. One of the strategic angles was international expansion. And during the first half of the year, a couple of things to note. One was the acquisition of Burlington Real Estate, a specialist property business in Ireland, where we hope to expand that going forward. And of course, also, we have a very strong forestry proposition. And in New Zealand, we acquired a £49 million portfolio of carbon credit and forestry portfolio in New Zealand. So major steps internationally during the first half of the year. But in addition to that, of course, we're a fund management business. We need to grow our assets under management. And we've done that through fundraisers in Grid, our energy storage vehicle, where it was well oversubscribed and £150 million ultimately was raised there. In addition to that, we raised our £75 million into our newest forestry fund. In our housing and affordable housing strategy, we raised £80 million. That comprised of, in our limited partnership, residential secured income limited partnership, and also £15 million in our residential PLC, our REIT that's listed on the London Stock Exchange. So all in all, our strategic targets remain very much focused, and we're on track towards achieving and surpassing those as we stand here today.
All right. And one of your key facets of your strategy there at Gresham House is sustainability and sustainable investing. What have you achieved in this area in the first half of 2022, would you say, Tony?
No, there's no question that this is something that's majorly important to investors alongside profit growth as well. Aside from our excellent progress in our real asset strategies that I've just outlined, we've also achieved some key sustainability milestones. We established a board sustainability committee, which is chaired by one of our senior independent non-exec, Gareth Davis. And we've also committed to setting some near-term science-based targets, which we're very close to establishing and publishing in the near future. Very important things. In addition to that, what is often well known is the UK Stewardship Code. And I'm really pleased that very recently we became a seal. We continued our signatory status for that.
All right, let's maybe get back to the numbers. Based on the numbers themselves, what's the outlook for the second half of the year and beyond, Kevin?
Well, we've set ourselves up with a very strong balance sheet for the second half of the year. So we had cash of 28 million, and we've got an undrawn RCF or facility of 20 million as well. So as we look to opportunities to invest and grow the balance sheet, but also ultimately grow our AUM, we're very well positioned on that front. We also have a good identified pipeline of investors across our LP funds and other distribution channels to help grow the business. So we remain very much on track to deliver against our targets for AUM growth in the second half of the year.
All right. And finally, Tony, what are the priorities for the second half of the year?
Well, the big picture remains to create shareholder value by growing assets under management and then obviously growing profits for the business. So as we look forward to the second half of the year, we can see further fundraising across all our strategies. We expect some closes, particularly in our real asset strategies, but we also recognise there's some of our fundraisers going on in our private equity areas and our public equity areas. So all in all, quite an exciting time despite the macro headwinds. In addition to that, we expect to generate further cash, which hopefully we will use to grow the dividend well in excess of inflation, which we committed to recently in our annual results. So all in all, some real key milestones we're expecting in the second half of the year and then into 2023.
All right. Tony and Kevin, thank you very much indeed from Gresham House here on Proactive London today.
Thank you.